Very good afternoon, students. Today I'm going to start unit 4, that is fuel chemistry. So everyone, we know that because of standards of living and technology, everyone, we people are depending on the vehicles. That means we are depending on the fuels. So fuels are very, very important. And these are playing an important role. But what is mean by the fuel? What is mean by the combustion? And what is mean by the fuel? And how we are going to refine the petrol from the crude oil? And how we are going to synthesize the gasoline? That means how we are going to synthesize the petrol in the good quality. That we can see in the unit 4. Yes? So let us see the introduction of the fuels. A fuel is a combustible substance containing carbon as the main constituent, which on proper burning gives a large amount of heat that can be used economically for domestic and industrial purpose. So what is mean by the fuel? Fuel is a substance that is a combustible substance containing carbon as the main constituent and which on proper burning gives a large amount of heat. So the fuel is nothing but simply we can say that any substance which on combustion releasing a large amount of heat energy is called the fuel. But here the fuel is having high amount of carbon. And during the process of combustion of your fuel, the atoms of carbon, hydrogen and remaining elements combine with oxygen with simultaneous liberation of heat. So when every element in the fuel, not only carbon and hydrogen, it is also having sulfur, nitrogen and oxygen. So when these elements are reacting, when these are undergo combustion, there is a releasing of heat energy in every reaction. So combined with oxygen. So the calorific value of your fuel depends mainly on the two elements, especially carbon and the hydrogen. So carbon is giving this much amount of heat energy and hydrogen is giving this much amount of heat energy when it is undergo combustion. But what is mean by the combustion? Combustion is nothing but burning in the presence of oxygen. A reaction with oxygen or burning with oxygen is called the combustion process. So carbon compounds have been used for many centuries as a source of heat and energy. So we know that carbon is a major element which is the main source of the heat energy. The main source of fuel is coal and petroleum. So generally we are getting the heat energy or the heat from either from petrol or from the coal. So these are stored fuels available in Earth's crust and are generally called fossil fuels because they were formed from the fossilized remains of plants and the animals. So why we are calling the fuels as a fossil fuel? Because these are getting from the fossilized plants and the animals. So because of that reason, the fuels are also called as a fossil fuels. This is the introduction of the fuels. So a classification of fuels. Fuels are classifying into two types. But before that, what is mean by the fuel? Fuel is a combustible substance which is having carbon as a major element and producing a large amount of heat energy. That is called the fuel. And what are the major elements present in the fuel? Carbon and the hydrogen. Along with the carbon and hydrogen, it is also containing sulfur, nitrogen and the oxygen in the minor portions. And there are two types of fuels. One is called the primary fuel and another one is called the secondary fuel. Primary fuel is nothing but which occur in nature as such as coal, petroleum and the natural gas. So the primary fuels are also called as the natural fuels. What is mean by the natural fuel? Natural fuel is nothing but the fuel which is synthesizing in the nature. That is called the natural fuel or the primary fuel. Secondary fuel, which are derived from the primary fuels. That means by using primary fuel, we are going to synthesize the secondary fuels. Secondary fuels are also called as the artificial fuels. These are also called as the synthetic fuels or man-made fuels. But how the secondary fuels are synthesizing? By using the primary fuels. So these are the derived from the primary fuels. For example, coke, gasoline, coal gas, etc. How the coke is synthesizing? By using coal. How the gasoline and these are synthesizing? By using the petroleum. So every time the secondary fuels are synthesized, these are derived from the primary fuels. So how many types of fuels we have? There are two types of fuels. One is called the natural fuel or the primary fuel. And the second one is a secondary fuel. This is also called as the artificial or man-made or the synthetic fuels. Both primary and secondary fuels may be further classified based upon their physical state. So based on the physical state, the every material or matter is existing in the three state. Yes, so even primary or the secondary fuels also available in the three states based on the physical state. One is a solid, liquid, and the gaseous fuels. So you know what is mean by the solid fuels? Solid fuels are nothing but the fuel which is existing in the solid state. Liquid fuels means the fuels which are existing in the liquid state. Gaseous fuels are nothing but the fuels which are existing in the gaseous state. So that is about the classification of the fuels. So now let us move to the next topic, that is calorific value. So in the previous slide, we have seen the carbon reaction and the hydrogen reaction. So when the carbon is undergo combustion, it is giving some amount of heat energy. And even when the hydrogen is undergo combustion, it is giving some amount of heat energy. That heat energy released in the combustion process is called the calorific value. But there are two types of calorific value, but the general definition, the general idea for the general understanding, I'm telling what is meant by the calorific value. So calorific value is nothing but the amount of heat energy released in the combustion process of the fuel. So calorific value of a fuel is the total quantity of heat liberated when a unit mass of the fuel or unit volume of the fuel is burnt completely. Yes. So when the fuel is burning, what is the amount of fuel? What is the amount of fuel? Maybe one unit. That means 1 gram or 1 ml of the fuel is undergo combustion. So when the 1 gram of the fuel or 1 ml of the fuel undergo combustion and releasing heat energy, that heat energy is called the calorific value. So simply calorific value means the total quantity of heat energy released when a unit mass or unit volume of fuel is burnt completely. That is mean by the calorific value. So there are some units of calorific value. One is calorie, kilocalorie, British thermal unit. These are the three units of the calorific value. Calorie, kilocalorie, and British thermal unit. So now let us see the classification of calorific value. So directly I have given here. But before that, the calorific value is classifying into two types. One is called the high calorific value and another one is called the low calorific value. Let us see what is mean by high and the low calorific value. High calorific value is also called as the gross calorific value. Low calorific value is also called as the net calorific value. So simply for understanding, for remembrance, I will give the simple definition of high and the low calorific value, but you should not write this answer in the external examination. High calorific value is nothing but calorific value in the closed chamber. But low calorific value is nothing but calorific value in the open combustion chamber. Yes, just remember this while explaining high and low calorific value. Again, I will explain with this concept. But high calorific value in the closed chamber and low calorific value in the open combustion chamber. So directly let us move to the topic, high or gross calorific value. Usually all fuels contain some hydrogen, and when the calorific value of hydrogen containing fuel is determined experimentally, the hydrogen is converted into steam. But when this it is converts to the steam, when the hydrogen is undergo combustion. Yes, the fuel is containing hydrogen, But when hydrogen is reacting with oxygen, what we are getting? We are getting the water vapor. Yes, that water vapor is nothing but the steam. But if the products of combustion are condensed, condensed are nothing but the cooled. When we are cool the products to the room temperature, when we are cooling the products to the room temperature, what is happening here? The vapor, the steam is converts to the liquid water. Yes, same thing is happening in the high calorific value. So when the water vapor is converts to the water, when the water vapor is converts to the water, some amount of heat is released here. In addition to the calorific value, the heat will be added due to conversion of steam to the liquid water. Yes, along with the calorific value, the other heat is added. That heat is called the latent heat of water vapor. What is the latent heat of water vapor? When the combustion products are cooling in the closed combustion chamber, in the closed combustion chamber, when the products are cooling, water vapor is converts to the water. So the heat is added to the calorific value. So the calorific value will be increasing here. So that increased calorific value is called the high calorific value. So if the products of combustion are condensed to the room temperature, the latent heat of condensation of steam also get included in the measured heat. What is the measured heat? Calorific value is the measured heat. So to the measured heat, the latent heat of water vapor will be added. From where latent heat of water vapor came? When the water vapor converts to the water, some amount of heat generated. That heat is called the latent heat of water vapor, which is included in the measured heat. So this is called the high calorific value or gross calorific value. So it is defined as the total amount of heat produced when unit mass or unit volume of the fuel has been burned completely and the products of combustion have been cooled to room temperature. Yes, that is high calorific value. So now just you assume when the combustion is taking place in the open combustion chamber, is there conversion of steam to liquid water? No, there is no steam formation in the container. Inside of the container, there is no steam. That steam will be escaping to the environment. So when the steam will be escaping to the environment, what is happening here? The heat value will be reduced. The reduced heat value is called the low calorific value. So in actual use of any fuel, the water vapor and moisture, etc. are not condensed and escape as such along with hot combustion gases. So even in our internal combustion chambers also, whatever the vehicles we are using, what is happening here? Those products, the combustion products are escaping to the environment. So hence a lesser amount of heat is available here. So net or lower calorific value is defined as the net heat produced when unit mass or unit volume of fuel is burned completely and the products are permitted to escape. So that is called the low calorific value. So simply in high calorific value, the products are cooled to room temperature and in the low calorific value, the products are allowed to escape in the environment. So there is a relation between low calorific value and the high calorific value. The relation is net calorific value. Net calorific value means low calorific value. Net calorific value is equals to gross calorific value minus latent heat of water vapor. Gross minus latent heat of water vapor. LCV is equals to HCV minus latent heat of water vapor. This latent heat of water vapor is equals to mass of hydrogen per unit into 9 into latent heat of water vapor. So simply you can remember one formula between LCV and HCV. LCV is equals to HCV minus 0.09 into H into 587. Yes, so this is a latent heat of water vapor value, that is the 587 kilocalories per mole. Yes, this is the formula you have to remember for the relation between LCV and HCV. So the next topic is the Dulong's formula. It is also very, very important in the external examination for the long answer question. Based on this, you will be having the long answer question and the numerical. So what is the use of Dulong's formula? Yes. So now everyone, you understood maybe what is LCV and HCV. Yes. Generally, the calorific values, that means LCV and HCV, these are calculating by using the instruments. We are having various instruments. Those instruments are called the calorimeters. What is the use of calorimeter? Calorimeter especially using to find out the calorific value. But instead of using instrument, we are using one of the mathematical expression to find out the calorific value. So especially Dulong's formula is using to find out the high calorific value or gross calorific value accurately. Approximately, this is equal to the instrument. So Dulong's formula is useful to find out the high calorific value accurately by using mathematical expression. So Dulong's formula for calorific value from the chemical composition of fuel is, this is the formula you have to remember. HCV is equals to 1 by 100 into 8080 carbon plus 34500 H minus O by 8 plus 2240 sulfur kilocalorie per kilogram. But how you got this expression? Yes. How we got the high calorific value from the Dulong's formula? According to the Dulong's formula, high calorific value is nothing but the sum of the calorific values of individual elements in the fuel. We know that every fuel is having carbon. Yes, carbon, it is having hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, and the nitrogen. When we add the calorific values of each and every element, we will get the high calorific value. That means what is the calorific value of carbon? 8080. And hydrogen, when we subtract oxygen from the hydrogen, we will get 34,500. This is the calorific value of these two. And sulfur calorific value is 2240. And whereas nitrogen is not there in the Dulong's formula because nitrogen's calorific value is zero. Yes. So this is the expression. How you got this expression? By adding the calorific values of each and every element in the formula, we got the high calorific value. So you have to remember this formula. And where carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and sulfur are the percentages of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and sulfur in the fuel respectively. So what are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur here? These are in the percentages. In this formula, oxygen is assumed to be present in combination with hydrogen as water, and LCV is equals to HCV minus, I said now, 0.09 into 587. 9 by 100 means 0.09. This is the formula of LCV. Yes. So this is based on the fact that one part of hydrogen by mass gives 9 part of the water. One part gives the 9 part of the water. And latent heat of water vapor is 587. So you have to remember these two formulas. This is the one, this is one formula, this is the Dulong's formula, and this is another expression to find out LCV and HCV. By using this formula, you can find out HCV, but in the external examination, they will give the percentage of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur. You have to substitute these values in the formula to find out high calorific value. After finding high calorific value, substitute this high calorific value in this formula to find out LCV. But already percentage of hydrogen given in the numerical. After substituting that, you can find out HCV and LCV. This is important for long answer question. So this we will see in the next class. A classification of the solid fuel is not part of our syllabus. So directly we will move to the analysis of cool. Yes. So with this, I'm going to conclude this session, and thank you so much.